Blending samples is not about harmony. It's about using samples, ensemble, that complement each other or have a relationship with each other, even though they may not have much of a strong point on their own. And what we're going to do is we're going to take a simple beat here and I'm going to build it up to show you my basic thought process. And in the process, we'll talk about how these samples blend together to my taste. So starting with the main theme, a lot of the times it's easy to see a drum as the foundation of your song. And while an atmospheric patch just like this one doesn't so much dictate rhythm or anything, it gives me a context that I want to play in. So this is like my canvas, and these are the limits that I'm going to play in. So everything is going to go into this atmospheric main theme, and that's where I'm going to draw the rest of the picture of this beat. So next we're going to bring in the snare. And this is the first real thing that's going to dictate a true rhythm. While you can kind of pick up the rhythm from the main theme, the snare really drives it home that, okay, this sounds like it's a 4/4 beat. It gives you the time signature right away, and it gives you a pulse. Now, it sounds off. Because it is. It's unquantized and it's sloppy playing by yours truly. That's cool, because there's a second snare that we're gonna bring in now. This snare is quantized, and you'll see that together, they've blend in creating the same pulse, but it's on time. One is slightly off the beaten track, one is dead on, and they're having a little conversation again. And that takes some of the mechanicalness out of the beat. Quantizing has its strong points, not quantizing has its strong points. Together, you can make them work. All right, so here comes the kick. Kick now, more than anything else that you're about to hear or have heard, adds swing and a true rhythmic boundary to what's being done here. It gives the snares a reason for being, it gives relevance to them, and it gives them something to play off. Again, they're all reacting off of that main theme that's going on, and they haven't gone outside that, nor will they. Now with the hi-hat, it's faint, because I didn't really want a hi-hat in this, but I wanted something to move the beat even more than it's moving right now, to play off of the actual kick. And in doing that, it's just slightly moving the beat forward. Not too exciting, nothing thrilling, just in the background, and not really meant to be heard, but it's there. So far, everything has a relationship, and everything's kind of being respectful of each other in this playground. Now, with this vocal element, it sounds disgusting on its own. It has no point, it has nothing there. And before I edited it down, it was part of a long vocal that sounded great, like it was amazing. But in this beat here, it made no sense. So I just took the beginning of the vocal breath and used that. And it worked because that works well with the main theme and it doesn't overtake anything. It's just there in the background, it's just cool. Lastly, we have the bass. And the bass is just something to let you know where the downbeat is and to add the melody, if any. How short it is, it gives you a motif to follow. A lot of vocalists, you'll find, play off the bass line even more than they do the beat, and this just lets them know where the punctuation parts are outside of the rhythm. The drum beat is the obvious thing, the bass line is the more driving thing. So once again, blending samples is a technique that really makes you true samples based on your main goal. Samples can sound amazing on their own, and then you drop them into a mix or you drop them into a beat, and they're too overpowered. And the art to blending is choosing samples that play together. This will allow you to have like a lot of samples happening at the same time, and it doesn't sound like a lot. Anyhow, thank you for watching. If you liked and learned something today, subscribe to me here on YouTube. Take yourself on down to thedaydreamsound.com. I will catch you on the next one. Peace.